respect him, President of this. First anniversary memorial meeting for Greg Banja. Distinguished and respected women leaders on the dais, Andhra Pradesh Communist Party State Secretary Comrade Narayana, and our Comrade Ramakrishna, because Narayana is in news now, that's why. And Comrade Ramakrishna and our senior leader, and my dear Andhra Pradesh Mahila Samakya ki comrades, and I know some of the other organizations leaders are also there from IDWA, and even I think the Mahila Congress, but the leader is here, but others are also there. And it is very, it gives me lot of strength and courage to speak about this situation, because I can see a lot of, almost half participants are the men in this hall, and we must next year we must try to bring in more and more young men in such memorial meetings and other meetings of the, particularly when we talk about women leaders. About Rajkumari, I have very little association with her as the member of the organization National Federation of Indian Women. But however short was our association or working together, what I observed from her is that she did not jump on everything. She will observe what we are, the experts are doing, and whenever a need arises, then only she will intervene and direct us, you should do like this or it will be better. She will not impose things on us. She will say that if you do like this, it will be better. And it is for us to whether to accept those suggestions or reject those suggestions. Even if we accept, she will not rejoice, or she will not say, okay, you have accepted my suggestions. Or we reject, she will not show any sort of displeasure or unhappiness. Though I suggested, I am a senior leader, but you rejected. No. She was a real leader of the women's movement. I need not explain all those things to you, because you were also part of her activities and you know her. What I am trying to say is about when I become the general secretary of this organization. Initially, even Rajkumari had some sort of a concern, because I suddenly came from a village and I did not know the socio-political atmosphere of the Delhi, the capital of our country, and I even did not know the language at that point of time. So there was, including Chandrabaji, Rajkumari ji, all the senior leaders at that point of time, they were, that was that moment of anxiety, and but they were all, they stood behind me, even though I did not have a national experience of organizing or leading any movement. But they stood behind me firmly, without intervening, without all the time pointing out some mistakes or anything. They showed confidence. And Rajkumari ji was one, I must say, that she never said that. It might not be in her mind, but she never spoken up that, I mean, this girl, can she carry out this huge responsibility, because this organization that sort of a conference with a caution, and my last meeting with her, I tell you, the election result of 2014 and 2019, that have actually that result took away some of one or two of our very fine comrades. And when I met Rajkumarini the last, she was so concerned about the people of this country. She was not worried about what will happen to NRMW or the CPI or all. She was concerned about the people of this country and the country itself, and its constitution, its democracy, its secularism. And she was, and Marina was with me. Rajkumarini was insisting that the position taken by the Communist Party of India, that is to have a larger collaboration with all left democratic and secular parties to prevent and to fight the fascist forces. We need to propagate this position of the party, and we need to work towards that larger joint movement and joint struggles for the sake of this country. This is what he was telling us when we visited Rajkumarini, when she was bedridden at that time, and this is what she was very much concerned. I was really wondering, even at that point of time, she was bedridden, she was not well, but she was not concerned about her health and her ailments. She was concerned about the people and the country. That is the generation, that is the real quality of a leader. And I think we, the new generation, need to, I say that new generation with my white hair, you may think that what is this lady saying? No, that generation of our leaders, they have passed that baton to us. Now it is our responsibility to carry. And if we are really, we need to learn and follow some of those principles and the examples which how they, the older generation and the people like Rajkumarini, the principles which they follow and the way they fought against all the anti-people policies and against the fascist forces. So these are the things I would like to share with you when we talk about Rajkumarini. And I, on behalf of the organization, the National Federation of Indian Women, I meet the almost 20 lakh women from all over the country, I pay my salute and my respect to Rajkumarini. Friends, when we are together here to maybe to celebrate Rajkumarini, her life, her struggles. When we are here to celebrate, the country is passing through a very, very critical and crucial situation. And particularly, I would like to say a few things about the women, because many people are here to speak and remember about Rajkumarini. So I will take one more, I will speak a few things about the women, because after Sri Narendra Modi became the cooking gas. For that, he is not saying anything. Women, the women who have got the free cylinder, free connections, need not pay, or all the refillings will be free. Not saying that. But always highlighting that I have given the free connections to women, and I have emancipated. That's why everywhere his photo and one women's photo with a gas cylinder is there. Again, you look at the triple talaq thing. What is it actually putting the Muslim women into more trouble? That triple talaq, we are also strongly against. Instead, triple talaq, there is no question of supporting that. But the way the act was, the bill was brought and the act was passed, it is very, very objectionable and putting the women, Muslim women, into more trouble. And again, look at the way the majority entitlement. He said, the occasion also we must see. After the demonetization, he said, I will come back to you, and if there is no result for this demonetization, then you can hang me. This is what he said. And on December 31st, he appeared again on TV, and he said, he did not say anything about the results of demonetization. How much money he could bring out, or how many people who are engaged in terrorism are, how many of them are arrested and brought before the law. There is no account. But he said only one thing. Hereafter, any women become pregnant in this country, all of them will get financial assistance of 5-6,000. Till that time, and the entire country celebrated, maternity entitlement became universal. But what happened? Till that time, the women were getting the assistance. It is through the National Food Security Act. For two deliveries they were getting. But after the announcement of this Prime Minister, how he betrayed the women, you must know. After that, it was reduced to only one delivery, that to the first delivery. And again, condition, the mother should be above 19 years old. On the one hand, they are propagating maternity entitlement has made universal. But in India, almost 35% of women becoming first time the mothers. They are 35% are becoming mothers below the age of 18, at the age of 13, 14, 15, 16, 35%. He has made a condition that the first the delivery should be the first delivery and the mother should be above the age of 18. But propaganda is that he has done everything for the women of this country. Like that, we can see many things. See, the maternity leave from 12 to 26 weeks. He said, we have given the women the maternity leave, increased the days. But for how many women? Only 4% women. forces. Even today, we are facing such a huge challenge, and the need of our is to carry forward the struggle and campaigns, and with a firm resolve that we will fight and we will defeat these fascist forces. That is what Rajkumariji and that generation showed us, and that needs a larger hand holding of all the organizations, particularly of women organizations, and women organizations are youth organizations. Women organizations are all other organizations of Kisan, students, Ken Mastur, and all other, and people. Even if there is a people are not in any organization, all people and organizations, we have to come together to save this country, its democracy, its secularism. If we need to sit like this together, and if we need to set them, or we need to see our children play together, live together, grow together, then this fight we will have to be in this fight. And I think that if we continue to fight, if we strengthen our fight, that will be the real homage for Rajkumariji. And I really thank the Andhra Pradesh Mahila Samaki, and I can see most of the family members, sister is there, and other members are also there, and we will carry on. I must assure the family that, and I must assure the Andhra Pradesh Mahila Samaki that we will continue our struggle till we achieve our aim and objectives, and we will ensure that whatever may be the challenges, we will be together, and we will fight, and we will win. Thank you very much.